Hi guys, this is Ashish from Edureka and welcome to the sixth video of Edureka's free Angular course for beginners. In this video, I'm going to talk about Angular router. In the previous video, we learned about different types of built-in directives categorized as attribute directives and structural directives. There we also learned how to create our own custom directive and implement it in your Angular application. So without doing any further delay, let's go ahead and understand what is an Angular router. Angular router is a very vital part of any application, because in any application you will be having multiple components and you need navigation in order to make your application more responsive and react. So basically, Angular router allows you to load the corresponding components for which a route has been requested. So in a nutshell, you can say that it allows you to control different routes with respect to different components. It allows you to control the data, the flow of data between different components, and the components that render the data. So as you can see in the image over here, we have four components as A, B, C, D. So basically, router will be responsible for all this navigation. So in any Angular application, if you are clicking on an about page and you are finally able to see, or finally your Angular application is able to render the about component in the specified area where you were expecting or where it was programmed, is because of router. So let's go ahead and understand how to use Angular router through code, because that's the best way to understand any concept regarding Angular. So I'll open my IDE. So this is the basic app, guys, the app that has been created by your Angular CLI. I have added few divisions over here for my, just to show that it is a demo for Angular routing. That's it. So now what we're going to do, we're going to create multiple components and then we will add route to them. So let's go ahead and start our work. So at first, let's go ahead and open our localhost 4200, where our application is being rendered, and put it on inspect mode. Now, what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to create a navigation bar, and in that navigation bar, we'll be having tabs for different components. So let's go ahead and create all the components. So I'm going to open a new terminal, and I'm going to go ahead with the command ngg component, and the first component will be home. So now that our home component has been created, let's go ahead with about component, and we'll also have something as block component. So all these three components has been created: about, block, and home. Now let's go back to our app.component.html, which is the first component to be rendered whenever your application gets started. So here I'm gonna go ahead and create a navigation bar. So let's go ahead and create a division. I want a container over here. And then inside that, I'm gonna go ahead with a row division, basically row class. So basically I'll be arranging all my tabs in an horizontal fashion. There I'm gonna go ahead and use an unordered list, which will be of class nav pills. Now I'll put my all of the tabs, or all those tabs corresponding to each component inside li tag. That is the list item. So let's go ahead and create an anchor tag over here where I'll be putting my links for different components. Now here I'm gonna go ahead with home first. Then I'm gonna copy it three times, duplicate it three times, and then I'm gonna go ahead with blog, and then at last I'll be having about. Alright, so let's go ahead and see how does our application looks like. As you can see, our navigation bar has been added. Now none of the routes has been added, so if I click on any of this button, can't see any component being rendered over here. Now basically I want my component to be rendered in this div tag. So I'm gonna go ahead and write place for the components. Alright. So as you can see, this is the area where I want my component. Whenever I click on one of these snap tabs, I want my component to be rendered over here. So now for adding route, you have to go to your app model, root model. You can also go ahead and create your own module for route. But for a very simple demo, I'm gonna go ahead with my app module, and therefore I'm going to add all the routes which will be available throughout the application. Now here we need to import something called as routes from @angular/router. So let's go ahead and do that first. From @angular/router. All right. Then what I need to do is I need to add all the routes, or you can say define all the routes with respect to all my components. So I'm going to go ahead and create a constant and name it as routes, which will be of type routes that we have imported just now. And we will initialize this constant with all those routes that we want to create or add for each component. So now I'm going to go ahead with a list. It accepts a list basically it accepts a list, which is a list of a JavaScript object. So I'm going to go ahead and create one JavaScript object inside. And then in each of these JavaScript objects, you have two fields. One is path, where you mention your route. And the second field is about the component to which you want to connect it. So for example, I'm going to go ahead with home component. And since it is the home component, that is the first component that should be rendered when you're going ahead with the domain name, then so that's why I'm going to go ahead with the empty path over here. Now I'm going to duplicate it again. And this will be my blog for my blog component. And then we have about component. And for that, the path will be about. Now, what I'm trying to do over here is basically, for example, in our case, since we are rendering our application in localhost, our domain name will be something like localhost 4200. So whenever you are starting your application or opening your application, at that time, you will be at this particular route, that is localhost colon 4200 slash. So for that, it will go ahead and render your home component. Once you are at your blog component, you want to go to the blog component, you will go to the path localhost 4200 slash blog. And therefore, we have added the path blog over here. Now, if you notice, we are not adding any slashes over here because that's what Angular router does for you. You don't need to go ahead and add those slashes. If you do that, it will show you an error. So that will be taken care of by your Angular router itself. So you don't need to worry about it. So now that we have defined all the routes, but it doesn't mean that your Angular router knows about it or knows where to fit it yet. For that, you need to register your route as well. So for that, you have been provided with a static method called as for route, which is available in router module. So we're going to go ahead and import router module. So this is our router module. And then I'm going to go ahead my imports array, and I'm going to use this router module. And then I'm going to call that method called as for route. And here you pass all the routes that you have defined so as to finally register them, so that then you can use it in your application. So I'm going to go ahead with my routes over here. Now we have defined all the routes and we have registered it. Now let's understand how to use it. So let's go back to our app.component.html. And what I'll do over here is I'm going to put all those routes that we have added just now. So I'm going to go ahead with slash for home, slash blog for blogs, and slash about for about. All right. Now let's do one more thing. Let's go ahead and add some text to our components. So for about, I'm going to say I am about component. Then I'm going to go to my blog component. And there I'm going to add blog component. And similarly, in my home component, I want it as I am home component. All right. In fact, we can add some image over here as well. That we'll do later on. For now, let's understand how does this route work. Now let's go back to our application. Now, if I click on blog over here, you can see that nothing is being rendered over here. And if I click on about, still your route is being added, but your corresponding component is not being rendered over here. So what you need to do is you need to specify the area where you want your component to be rendered or loaded. So for that, you're gonna go ahead and use something called as router outlet, which is a directive provided by your Angular router. What it does is it basically loads that component for which the route has been called in the area where you have put that router outlet directive. So for example, I'm going to go ahead and put my router outlet directive over here. So router outlet slash router outlet. If you see over here, if you observe, then it will look like as if you're going ahead with some component selector tag, but basically it's a directive. So don't get confused about it. You can go ahead and use selector tag for a directive as well for loading a particular directive. Basically, as we have discussed earlier, that a component is essentially a directive with a view. So let's go ahead and check out whether it is working or not. So you can see that we have in our about route, and we have that about component being rendered on that very area where we have put our router outlet. So now if I go to my blog, you can see that blog component is also being rendered over here. Similarly, if I go to my home component, I can see that the home component is also being rendered. So for now, one thing is very clear that we have created the route and we have registered them successfully as well because the routes are working. Now the problem is whenever I click on a particular component or whenever I request a particular route, your application gets reloaded. So if you notice this reloading icon over there, page reload icon, and if I click on any of the component, you can see that the entire application is being loaded again. And as we have discussed that Angular is used for creating single page applications that are loaded once. That's the main idea behind using single page application or behind developing a single page application, so as to get that reactiveness out of your application as if you're using a native application or a mobile application. And also, as you know, that a single page application is made up of a single page that are loaded once, that is in the beginning when you visit that particular website. So this is something that we don't want over here. So for that, what we need to do, we need to go ahead and use something called as router link, which is again a directive that allows you to render or load up a particular component for which the route has been requested without reloading the page. So let's go ahead and understand how does that router link stop the page reloading whenever you are requesting a particular route. So for using router link, what you have to do is, instead of using your href, I'm going to go ahead and use something called as router link. And here I'm going to mention the path that I want to add for this particular tab. So I'm going to go ahead and mention my path as slash for my home. Similarly, for my blog, I want to go ahead with router link. And for about, I'm going to copy this again. All right. So now if I click on any of this button, you can see that the page reload has been stopped. So no more that web application is reloading again whenever you are requesting for a particular component or whenever you're requesting a route for a particular component. You can also go ahead and do this like localhost. You can go ahead and paste the actual URL so as to visit a particular component. For example, I can go ahead with 4200/blog, but again, that will reload the entire application, so that doesn't make any sense. Now, what I want to do is I want to use a class called as active, which is a Bootstrap CSS class that signifies which tab is currently active. So as you can see, if I'm at home, in general, whenever your application is being started, at that time you will be at home. So you can see that home tab is being activated. Now, if I go to any other tabs are not being highlighted as the current tab. So for that, what I can do is, you can go ahead and use something called as outer link active class. What it will do, it will load that active CSS class, your Bootstrap class, and will add it to your styling whenever you are at that particular route. For example, what I'm trying to say is, I'm going to go ahead and use router link active, and now I've set it to my active class. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to copy it and paste it in my all the tabs. Now if I go there, as you can see, whenever you are at a particular tab, that tab is being highlighted. But thing to notice over here is that your home tab is always being highlighted. The reason is that the route for your home, that is your localhost 4200/, is always there. So whenever you are at any of the component or you are at any of the routes, you will have that localhost :4200 as a part of your entire route. So that's why that particular tab is being highlighted even if you are on a different tab currently. So for that, what we need to do is to fix that up. You can use an option for router link, which is router link active options. Now, using this, you will be given with multiple options. One of the options is so as to fix this issue that we are having. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to initialize it with exact true. So this is what we are passing over here. But remember, here we are passing a JavaScript object. And you cannot go ahead and assign a JavaScript object inside double quotes. For that, you need to go ahead with property binding. So I'm going to go ahead with this property binding over here. And now you can see if I am at home, we are seeing the home path or home tab being rendered over here. Now at blog, you can see that blog section or blog tab is the only tab that is being highlighted. So basically, it's matching the exact route for a particular component. So for example, if I'm at about, it's looking at the complete route as localhost 4200/about. So that's why he's going ahead with the exact route, and for that he's highlighting the, or he's loading up the correct CSS class that we have provided over here, active. So now that we have understood all these, now let's go ahead and understand how to add a route or how to add a navigation in your business logic or programmatically. So what if you, on a click of a certain button, or if a person has finished the sign up form and finally you want that guy to be redirected to your home page, so for that, what you will do? So let's go ahead and understand how to do that. So what I'll do is, I'll go to my home component, and in this home component, so let's go ahead and insert an image, and basically I'm going to load my image from Edureka edureka.co/blog. So this is the blog section of our Edureka's website. Here you will get tons of blogs about different technologies. For example, for Angular, you need to go ahead with Angular. And as you can see, these are the blogs that has been written for Angular. You can go ahead and check out these blogs as well. So I'm going to go ahead and use this particular image. So copy image address, and then I'm going to go ahead and add it inside my source. All right. Now let's add some width as well. 300, and for height, let's use the same 300. All right. So now if I go to my home page, I can see that particular image over there. Let me put it in a center. And let me add this image over there. So that is in the center. Let me remove this for now. And then I'm going to add h2 tag stating welcome to Angular tutorial by Edureka. So this is the page. Now what I want is, whenever I click on this particular image, I want my blog section to be opened up. So let's go ahead and fix our blog component as well. For example, let's go ahead with an h2 tag as Angular architecture. Then we need an image. Now let me go back to the blog. So now here I'll grab that image, that architecture image, copy image address. Let's go ahead and reduce the width. Width equal to 50%, and then height equals to 50%. Yes, it's correct. Now let's do one more thing. Let's bring it on center, text center. Let's add some paragraph as well. So let's add this paragraph. In fact, put it below it. Text justify. All right. Now I can see my blog over here. That's absolutely fine. Now let's do one more thing. Let's remove this place for components for now, since we have understood what our outer outlet directive does. Now, what I want is, let's enter this architecture as well. So what I want is, whenever I am at my home and whenever I click on this image, I want my blog sections to be opened up. Basically, I want to show you how to navigate to a different routes programmatically or using your business logic, using the code that is inside your business logic. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead with my home component.ts and my home component.html. Here, I'm going to add a click. Let's go ahead and have a div tag so as to make it a bit presentable and easy to understand. Then I'm going to put my image and I'm going to add an event click event, and I'm going to map it to a function go to blogs. All right, I'll go to my home component to create that particular function that we have just binded with our click event on that image. Now here I'm going to go ahead with go to blogs. Now here what I want to do is I want to go ahead and navigate to my blog section. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and import something called as router from @angular/router. And then I'm going to use something called as dependency injection so as to create an instance of that router that we have just imported. I'm going to go ahead with private router, which will be of type router. All right. Now I'm going to use it, this dot router dot navigate. So these are the function that has been provided by your router. So I'm going to use the first one, that is navigate. And here what you do, you provide your path. Basically, you will be going ahead with a list, and there you can go ahead with multiple routes as well. So for now, we're going to go ahead with a single route, and that will be /blog. All right. So now if I click on this image, as you can see, we have been directed to our blog component. Now there's one more thing to discuss over here, is something called is about your relative route and absolute route. So what is happening over here is this slash trailing slash indicates that you are going ahead with your absolute path. For example, let's go back to our app.component.html, and what I can do is if I go ahead with my blog only, all right, and if I'm at my home page And now if I click on blog, so what it will do, it will think of it as a relative route and it will append this part of route after the current route on which you are currently are. So what I'm trying to say is, so let's do one more thing. Let's go ahead to our blog component and there let's add an anchor tag, and this time let's go ahead with router link and just add about. All right, and this is go to about page. All right, so if I go to my blog, you can see we are having that link over here. Now if I click on it, you can see that the error that is coming over here is cannot match any routes because the URL segment that we are talking about is blog/about. So basically what is happening over here is, since we haven't provided any trailing slashes, so it's considering as a relative route. So what is happening over here is, so in, if you are on a blog component or in your blog route, so it's adding that slash about in the end of the current route and which we haven't registered or which we haven't defined in our root module. So if we can go ahead to our root module, and what we can do is we can change the path of your about component as blog/about. If I do that, then this particular link will work. So if I now do that, as you can see, am about component is working. But again, as you can see, that active tab is not working, that router link active, because we haven't provided the correct path for which it will load the active CSS class. For example, if I go to my app.component.html and then I'm provided over here is /blog/about. If I do that, now as you can see, we are having that particular about component, about tab being active. Now again, the same reason because of which your home tab was being activated all the time, because you have your slash blog path or route in your entire URL as a part of your URL. That's why your blog tab is also being activated. So again, what you have to do, you have to do the same thing. You have to use this router link active options, and there you have to go ahead with and put it inside your tab for blog section. So now, yes, you can see, now we have no problem in navigating between different tabs, and we are having the correct tab being highlighted as our current tab, none other tab at the same time. So now that you have understood about relative path and absolute path, or basically relative routes or absolute route, so for that, always remember, if you are going ahead with trailing slashes over here for your router link directive, that means that it is an absolute path. And if you're going ahead without any slashes, at that time it will be a relative path. So now for now, let's go ahead and fix it. So I'll remove this. Then I'll go to my app module, and there I'm gonna remove this as well. Now, as you can see, everything is working. So this is how you add routes to your Angular application, guys. It's pretty much easy to use. All you have to do is you have to use directive called as router outlet for loading or for specifying the area where you want to load your component for which the route has been requested. The second thing you have to do is you have to use router link so that your page load doesn't happen each time when you are navigating between different routes. Third thing is you have to take care about relative routes and absolute routes. Fourth thing is that you have to define all the routes in your root model, and then you have to register them using router model dot for root method. That is a static method. So we have learned all about routes, guys. I guess now you can understand why routes are so important for single page application, because router are the ones that gives you that feeling as if you are using a website having multiple pages, but in reality it is made up of a single page. And whenever you go ahead and navigate through different routes, you don't have to go ahead with a page reload. Therefore, you get that responsiveness as if you are going ahead with your mobile application or native desktop applications. So guys, I hope this session was informative or helpful for you. Now in the next video, I'll be talking about Angular forms. There are two different types of forms that your Angular provides. One is called as reactive and the other is template driven. We learn about them and how to use them, how to add different validation rules to your form. We learn about all that. And then once we have understood all of these, we're gonna go ahead and apply all our understanding in Angular services, where we'll be creating a CRUD application. And then after that also, we're gonna go ahead with a CRUD application demo. There, I'm gonna show you how to connect your front end with back end as well. And we'll be going ahead with all those HTTP methods for retrieving, for creating, for updating, or for deleting any of the data and interacting with your server. So see you in the next video, guys. Till then, have fun. Bye.
I hope you enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply to them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to our Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!